Hello. So today we're going to be doing my June makeup basket or everyday makeup drawer, however you want to call it, and a recap of my May makeup basket, everyday makeup drawer. So before we get into it, make sure you're subscribed before you leave and give this video a big thumbs up so I know to keep doing this style of video. And you can follow me on my makeup related Instagram. All that stuff is always down below. Let's dive right in. If you didn't see my May monthly mask makeup, if you didn't see my May monthly basket, I will link that video down below and in the card for you. Basically, I just picked out products that I wanted to focus on during the month, and then I set little goals for myself for each product. I definitely recommend checking that one out because a lot of this video is going to be kind of talking about the products in that video. I will put a timestamp if you just want to see the products that I'm rolling in for June. But yeah, so I had little goals for myself for almost each of the products. I had 26 products in total, and let's just go through how I did. I also took before and after shots, so I will insert that on the screen, just to see how much product or progress I've made with each product. So I had picked out four eyeshadow palettes for May to use throughout the month. I had set the goal to use each of them 5 times, which didn't happen. But it did happen for this guy right here. This is the ColourPop and Kathleen Lanch Dream Street palette. And I actually didn't realize this was discontinued. But you can see I definitely made a lot of progress on that shade. I also made a little bit of progress on this shade because the day that I used it was not cooperating and kept having to dip back in my brush or in the pan to get pigment on my brush. So there is like a little bit of a dip there. I don't even think you'll be able to see it, but there is. So I did use this all 5 times. I used this in a 1 week one palette on my Instagram, and that's pretty much why I was able to hit the 5-time mark. I have to say, when I'm doing my next 1 week one palette, which is actually this coming week, this video should be going up on Sunday. So the week that this goes live is I'm doing a 1 week one palette with the Tati Beauty palette, so you can check that out. But yeah, so I had used this on my eyes 5 times. The next palette that I used was this Natasha Denona Mini Retro palette, and I just got this. Which is why I threw it in my May's basket because I really wanted to test it out this month. So I ended up using this about 4 times. I did do a video on this palette, which will be coming up shortly. I did like how many looks can I create with just this 5-pan palette. So check that out if you're interested when that goes live. Should be like Thursday, I think. I'm not sure. So I really like this palette. It's really, really pretty. I love the shimmers. I love how secretly versatile this is. So I'm really glad I got to use it this month. The next palette I was supposed to use was this Smashbox Sultry palette, and I ended up only using this 2 out of 5 times. I just feel like because it was so the same tones, kind of like it's almost all the same kind of shades, I just wasn't really drawn to it. I really love this shade though. I really love this palette. I just like don't really use it. So I only use this twice. The last eyeshadow palette that I was supposed to use was this Smith and Colt Book of Eyes Noon Suite. And it just looks like that. It's just a little quad. And I ended up using this 3 times. So again, this is like a very simple palette. So it's definitely great for every day, and I really enjoy the shimmers. They're really, really soft, and buttery. I don't know. I was just kind of not really using it. There's no really particular reason why. I really like that palette. I like the formula. I just didn't use it all 5 times. I feel like towards the end of the month, I wasn't wearing makeup that much, or I wasn't at least wearing eyeshadow. So like that really didn't help me at all. Okay, so I had 2 primers in my May basket. One was the Becca Cosmetics Backlight Priming Filter and the Soap and Glory One Heck of a Blot Mattifying Primer. So I used this Becca one 6 times and I used the Soap and Glory 5 times. I didn't have a specific goal for these, I just tracked how often I use them. So yeah. I also had 2 foundations in the mix. This is the Catrice HD Liquid Coverage Foundation and the Wander Beauty Nude Illusion Foundation. I used the Wander Beauty 7 times and the Catrice 3 times. This one, I've said it before, I really, really love this foundation. I feel like it looks really, really nice on your skin, but it oxidizes so badly on me. So one day, like, I wore it and I was just like, my face is an entirely different color than the rest of my body. So I just kind of stayed away from it for the rest of the month. Okay, so I had 4 lippies in my May basket. The Buxom Lip Gloss I used 3 times. The Dreamy Ultra Satin Lip by ColourPop I used 4 times. The Milani Naturally Chic Lipstick I used 3 times. And the Essence Cool Nude Lipstick I used 3 times. So I didn't do that bad on lipsticks. So I feel like I do not wear lipstick on an everyday basis. Or I'll put a lipstick on in the morning and then I won't like touch it up throughout the day. So I feel like that was pretty good because I used it 3, 6, 9, 12... 13 times. So I used a lipstick pretty much 13 days. So yeah, the Jante Blue eyeliner I used 7 times. I was supposed to use it 10 times and I didn't. I just don't wear eyeliner on an everyday basis either. Obviously, I pretty much probably only wore eyeliner 7 times this month. I would, or give or take a few days, but yeah, so I really do like this eyeliner. I didn't put it in because I don't use it. I just put it in so that I would use an eyeliner, if that makes sense. Next is blushes. So I used this Burt's Bees blush 5 times. That was my goal for this blush and all the blushes, to use them 5 times. So I ended up using the Burt's Bees 5 times. The Dome Beauty one 6 times, which I freaking love this blush. I don't know. It is so beautiful. I will have a video of makeup that I literally cannot put down, like I've been using constantly and it's getting redundant. I will link that. I don't think it's gonna be up yet. No, it's not gonna be up, but it'll be up soon, so you can check that out when that goes live. But this blush is in that video. And then my LA Girl blush I only used 3 times. There's nothing wrong with this blush. I think it's really pretty and I like the tone of it and it's super pigmented. I just didn't reach for it. I had 4 highlighters in my makeup basket this month. I had the Ofra Rodeo Drive highlighter and I used this one 4 times and I feel like you can see a little bit of the progress here because I definitely, like, you can definitely see the little like cross there. So I'm excited about that. I used this Space Case one 2 times. I really do like this highlighter. I just don't really reach for this packaging all that much. See, like, now I can't get it back on. Okay. The IBY highlighter I used 2 times. This is a beautiful one as well. I don't know. Something about these smaller packaging I also don't reach for. And the Temp 2 BoxyCharm Liquid Glow I reached for 3 times. The Brow Gal I used 9 out of the 10 times. And you can definitely see I've made a little bit of progress here. So happy about that. And the Benefit Cosmetics Gimme Brow I used 10 out of 10 times. So that's pretty good. I used this bronzer by Ofra Cosmetics and Samantha March 8 times this month. I didn't have like a specific goal for this one, but I used it 8 times. So okay, and then I had 3 skincare pieces. So the first one was this Pixi Beauty cleanser and I used this 18 times. I use this pretty much night and morning for the most part every day. Obviously not every day, but like for the most part I was using this cleanser. I like this one. I saw on Instagram that someone said it has a pH of 9.5, which is very high and it's not great for your skin and it's stripping for your skin. I don't find that this is over drying. I have definitely other cleansers that definitely dry me out and this isn't one of them. So I don't know, just keep that in mind if you follow that kind of stuff. I used this Juice Beauty Stem Cellular. The Juice Beauty Stem Cellular Anti-Wrinkle Eye Treatment. I used this 8 times. 9 times. I used this 9 times. So that's pretty good. I tried to use all the skincare at least 10. So 9 out of 10, I'll take it. And then this Youth to the People Superberry Hydrate and Glow Create Mask. Or Dream Mask. Where did I get Create? Dream Mask. I used 6 times. So not bad, but I didn't really make, you know, any progress on this. This is fairly new, so it's not like a big deal that I didn't really use it that much, and I'll probably continue to use it. I do like it. It's hydrating. So yeah, so for the most part, I hit my goals kind of like 25% of the time. But yeah, let's move on to June's makeup basket. I got a comment in my last video that they wanted to see me actually picking out the products, so I did that this time, so roll the clip.
Okay, so this is like my bronzers and blushes in here, so let's go through and pick some out. Maybe I'll pull this bronzer, actually. I know that was like the second thing I pulled, but I haven't used this in a while. This is the e.l.f. Forever Sunkissed Primer Infused Bronzer. So let's do that one. And for blush, I want to pull this palette. Actually, this is the Sof X and Makeup Revolution collaboration. I think I could probably hit pan on either of these shades, so let's pull that. And for blush, I'm going to pull these two cream products. This is from Flower Beauty. It's the Pinched Cream Blush, and then this is from All Naturelle. And it is the Cream Multi-Stick in Grapefruit. So it looks like this. I've definitely used this on my channel before. So yeah, I really like this one. And then I'm also going to pull this because I just got it and I kind of want to play with it. So this is the Cheek to Chic from Charlotte Tilbury in the shade Pillow Talk. Highlight, I'm grabbing this Anastasia one just as well as the Sof X palette so I don't get bored. Okay, so I've gotten these new eyeliners from Laura Geller that my mom got me for my birthday. So I think I'm going to just pull all four of these and see how it goes. There's a green, a brown, a black, and a navy. So yeah, I'm just going to pull all four and just see if I use any of them. If I want anything else from this drawer. No, I'm not going to get anything else from this drawer right now. I'm going to pull the Tati Beauty Volume 1 palette. Yeah. Ooh, look at that shift. You see those shimmers? Ooh. All right, so we have that one. I'm also going to put in my rotation my Pan That Palette palette because I'm not using this at all. So I want to like do a 1 week, one palette with this guy. And I think I'm also going to pick this one So Jaded palette from ColourPop because I feel like I haven't reached for it in a minute. So I'm going to take that one too. So we have a couple like single shades in here. So maybe I'll just pull some of these. Maybe I'll just do this Laura Mercier one. This is the Shadow Stick in the shade Sand Glow. So I'll do this too. For primer, I'm going to pull my blurring primer from Cover of X, and I'll pull this guy too. This is the Ole Henriksen Banana Bright Primer. Okay, this is like my foundation concealer drawer, so I think I'm just going to pull, looking at it, I feel like I haven't played with this a lot, so maybe I will try and play with this. This is a Physicians Formula Organic Wear Silk Foundation Elixir. And I'll grab my Born This Way concealer too. I don't want to limit myself as much with just a couple foundations this time around, so yeah, I'm just going to grab those two things. For lippies, I think I want to pull I'm going to pull these four lippies. So this is the Dominique Cosmetics Lemonade Lip Gloss. And then these three from Physicians Formula. They're the Rosé Play All Day or Rosé Kiss All Day lippies in the shades Pillow Talk, Blushing Mauve, and First Kiss.
Okay, so for most of the products this time around, I gave myself a goal of 5 uses. For my Tati Beauty palette, my Pan That palette, And my So Jaded palette, I'm using them 5 times this month. Like I said, I'm using the Tati Beauty all this week, so check that out on my Instagram if you're interested. For the 2 primers I'm using, I am going to be trying to use them 5 times as well. I'm so excited about these lippies. I picked them on purpose because they're like perfect, like spring summer shades, and they're just really, really easy to apply, and I just feel like I will get a lot of use out of them because I love them. So I'm going to try and use each of these 5 times. I don't know if that's really gonna happen because I tend to just stick towards the gloss and the Pillow Talk shade, but we'll see what happens. So I only picked 1 foundation this time around because I really didn't want to limit myself, but I do want to get some use out of this specific foundation because I haven't used it in a while. So I'm gonna try and use it, or I haven't used it like ever, basically. I wanted to try and use it at least 5 times and we'll see what happens. I literally have no opinion on this foundation because like I've used it like once or twice, so I really want to get an opinion on this guy. So I picked out 2 cream blushes. Well, this one's like a cream and this one's like a stick. So I picked out a good variety of blushes this time around, and I think a good mix of shades. So I've been really getting into cream products lately. As you know, I've been using like the Fenty product literally every single day, and so I really wanted to try my blushes back out. So this isn't my like favorite formula, but I do think it's very, very pretty. So this shade is the shade Pinched, and then I have the Au Naturel one in the shade Grapefruit. So I'm excited. And then I have this guy because I just got it and I want to play around with it. So I'm going to try and use all of these at least 5 times. Picked out this palette because I reach for it quite a bit, and I think maybe if I use it enough this time, I will be able to hit pan on this shade because I feel like I'm pretty close. So I'm excited about that. And then the Anastasia one, I just haven't used in a while, and oh, so pretty. I want to get into that. Let's use it right now, actually. Because I didn't put any highlighter on. So yeah, I'll try and use those 5 times. The bronzer is the only thing in the basket that I'm going to try and use at least 10 times. Because I feel like I use bronzer almost on an everyday basis. So it'll be pretty easy for me. And then I also picked out this little Laura Mercier Caviar, I think it's called the Caviar Stick Eye Color. It's this beautiful kind of like a golden brown taupey shade. It's a perfect all over the lid shade when you're just trying to get out the door. Like you just want to go doot, 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 blend in with your fingers and you're done. So I'm going to try and use this 3 times. Oh. I don't believe in myself, apparently. I did this yesterday, and I like went through and I don't know, but I guess 3 times. I guess because I have other palettes that I want to use, I don't think I'm going to pair this thing with the palette. So I'll try and use it at least 3 times. Probably will try and use at least 5 though, if we're being honest. I pulled my Born This Way by Too Faced multi-use sculpting concealer. This is in the shade Pearl. I haven't used this in a while again, so I just kind of wanted to rotate it into my collection. And then the last items that I don't have like a set goal for, but I do want to just use these this month, are these Laura Geller eyeliners. So I have a green, a blue, a black, and a brown. I had gotten these for my birthday, so I just really want to try them out. I don't believe I've ever tried liquid eyeliners from her. I know I've tried powder, I've tried, you know, lip products, that kind of thing. So I do want to try and get some use out of these this month. So that completes this video. Make sure you follow me on Instagram. I know I've said it at least 7 times in this video, but like I do a lot of daily updates with this stuff. So if you're interested in this kind of stuff and makeup of the day and like get ready with me, like I definitely do more everyday stuff on my Instagram. So highly recommend checking that out. I am hosting a giveaway currently as well, so you can check that out. If you are subscribed to my channel, that is an extra entry. So thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you in my next video. Bye.